Group jobs on the AS400 provide the facility of switching from one interactive job to another. Consider an example. An operator is entering orders at a terminal. Sometimes he also gets queries from customers as well as suppliers, which he has to respond to. Normally, he would probably end the order entry application, switch over to the inquiry program. After responding to the query, he will once again restart the order entry application. Both these methods, as well as other alternatives like nesting menus or having a single application for all options, are not very practical and also affect the performance. Using the system request key to switch between jobs is quite an efficient method but works only with two jobs. Group jobs provide an efficient solution to this problem. Let us see how the previous example works as a group job. The data entry operator is running the order entry applications. Say a request comes from a customer for some information. The operator signals to the system that he needs to suspend the current job. He will then be presented with a menu from which he chooses the option for customer inquiry. After he finishes processing the customer request, he can once again signal to the system. His current job will also get suspended. He will be presented with a menu from which he can either start off a new group job or he could go back to the suspended order entry job. If he goes back to the order entry job, he will be presented the screen from where he left off and he can continue processing the order. The attention key is used to signal to the OS400 that the user wishes to switch jobs. When the attention key is pressed, the OS400 passes control to a user-defined program or menu from which the user can select the required option. You have up to a maximum of 16 jobs running under one group job. All the jobs in the group job run under the same user profile and are only applicable for interactive jobs. Each job, however, will have its own PAG, job log, Qtemp library, spool files, etc. However, it adopts the job attributes such as library list and output queue from the job that initiated it. You create a group job by converting your current interactive job into a group job using the change group attribute command. This causes the system to establish a group job environment. The system automatically creates a group data area for the group job. We can specify a program that is to be run when the user presses the attention key. This program usually displays a menu from which the user can select an option to switch to or start up a particular group job. To identify the attention key handling program, we can either use the setAttentionProgram command in each group job or use the changeUserProfile command with the ATNPGM parameter set with the same name of the program. The attention key handling program, as we just mentioned, normally displays a menu showing the options that the user can choose from while the current group job is suspended. Depending on the option selected by the user, the attention key handling program uses the transfer group job command to start up a new group job or to resume a suspended job. Each group job either ends normally after completing its logic or can be ended by the end of group job command. The primary group job can be made a non-group job by using the change group attribute command with the job parameter set to star none. Alternatively, we could also either use the end job command to end all the jobs or sign off from the system, which will also cause all group jobs to be ended. Let us look at the group data area that is created automatically by the system when a group job is established. There can be only one group data area for one group job. It has a length of 512 bytes, which can hold character data and is initially filled with blanks. The group data area is used to communicate information among the jobs in the same group. The group data area is automatically destroyed when the last job in the group is terminated. As with local data areas, a group data area is not associated with any library, and neither you can create or delete the group data area. The jobs in the group access the data area using the retrieve data area, change data area, display data area command with the data area parameter set to star GDA. Some of the advantages of using group jobs are: PAG size is reduced, programs do not have to be initiated repeatedly, hence minimizing on the number of file opens and closes. There is no need to terminate one function before starting another. Group jobs give the user the facility to skip between different functions in a quick and efficient manner. This completes our discussion on group jobs. In this chapter, we saw how to convert an interactive job into a group job. We saw how group jobs facilitated users to switch between applications without having to end one before starting another. We saw the change group attribute command and also saw the group data area that was associated with group jobs. We saw how the attention key was used to switch between jobs, and we also saw the attention key handling program.